So we are here in the center of Belgrade, in U10 Gallery. This is a non-profit space, and I like the similar spaces all around Europe, because they are independent and they can do whatever they like, and they're not dependent on the on any institutional or government or stuff like that. So please tell me something about the story of the U10.
Yeah, so U10 Art Space, we prefer to be called Art Space, not a gallery. Yeah. It was founded in May 2012, so 9 years ago, by seven young artists who all graduated in painting here from the Faculty of Fine Arts in Belgrade. And actually at the time, the scene, the Belgrade contemporary art scene, was maybe a little bit different than now, because now there are maybe more spaces, and especially for young artists. But back then, they kind of faced, they and their generation, and maybe even before, with the situation where there are some spaces for exhibition for like established artists, and also we had a lot of spaces for students, art students. But there was this kind of gap of what do you do if you're just graduated, you don't have any career, you never had your solo show, you don't know how maybe even to do it, and you want to start. So because there was not a space like that here in Belgrade, they decided to act, and they founded this space. And in the beginning, their plan was maybe to have it just a short term, and then later on to develop in a different way. But actually, the reaction from audience was pretty good, and it was obvious after a couple of months that the space like this was needed in Belgrade. So it stayed, and of course, during these 9 years, it developed in certain ways. But this main goal that was here from the beginning, which is to present the younger generation of artists, is still the main for U10.
It's interesting because usually independent art spaces has a good connection between artists. Usually friends or close ones who try to establish a place and fill it with artwork and stuff like that. And do you feel the same in U10?
Well, definitely. I mean, U10 started. I mean, they're of course colleagues, but they're also a group of friends. So between them, they are friends, and we're all friends. Yeah. And these first shows that were shown here, like the first one was the seven of them plus several artists that are from their generation. And then they had their solo shows, and also solo shows of artists, their colleagues, their friends, and you know, the people they thought that their work should be, you know, seen in Belgrade. So I think that this kind of connection that we have between ourselves, between the people who are making the scene and who are making the space, is crucial actually, and this collaboration that is really the bond that, you know, is actually present all this time, and maybe the reason that why this exists for such a long time. And it's easier to do everything, of course, with this kind of positive, you know, energy, and with all these positive connections. And that sounds maybe a little bit washed out, but it's really actually like that. And I think that that is also the case, like when we have, because we have a lot of shows during annually here, and when we get this kind of afterwards, you know, like kind of reaction from the artists that we're showing that they felt good doing this, then we know that it's the right thing to do.
You are not stated that you are a feminist gallery, of course, but the majority of your exhibitors are still females. So how this happened?
Well, I think, well, we are in the way a feminist gallery, that I think that we're all feminists, I mean, in that way. But I mean, actually, maybe that's just a coincidence. For example, this show that we're currently in is really a show with only female artists, and also the curator is female. Mm-hmm. But I don't know, like, the statistics, but I think that it's kind of really equal when it comes to gender. And also maybe you can, because in the collective there are like seven original people, five females and two only males, but I think also it's just kind of a coincidence. I don't think that's a kind of a statement, you know. So I, of course, we are feminist in the way that we support everybody equally. Mm-hmm.
Is it hard to have an independent space here? I mean, everywhere it's yes. Hard. Yeah, but are there any special problems?
Well, I think that the thing with Belgrade and with Serbia, of course, like we're not a very, you know, rich country, and then all the problems that everybody has in the, like in the world, it's even harder when you come from a poor country, especially the country that doesn't, for example, invest so much in culture, in art, as you know, from the government and from the institutions. So in that way, it's maybe like harder than somewhere where everything is better. But I think it's just kind of what comes from, you know, the state of our like society in general, and then it just kind of also goes to the art scene, to the culture, and so on. But is it hard to have like the art space here? I think yes. Maybe somebody would even say that it's impossible, but it's obviously possible.
Yeah, I have also noticed from for example Paris or even London that the places are getting more and more expensive, and actually too expensive for an artist who is not working 8 hours in a bank.
Yeah.
And they are moving away. So how is it working here?
Well, that's like the topic of all times, I would say. Yeah, the artists living here, I suppose it's again not an easy thing. I think that a lot of artists, for example, do, you know, some jobs beside their art practice. Especially young artists, it's really hard to kind of, you know, get to the point of your career where you can just do your art and live from it. But it is possible. I mean, we just recently had this situation, for example, because there was this space, you maybe talked even to Nina about it, where they were in this old factory and then it was sold and they were all kicked out, not only visual artists but also musicians and a lot of other organization, sport organization and so on. So it was like in a month they, like a lot of, like I don't know, hundreds of people had to find another solution how to continue their work and to find space where to work, like really quickly. So I don't know, it's just there is no kind of support from the government, or it's not very present. So I think it's up to the artists to manage to find their place.
Yeah, I found even here in this exhibition a piece with houses to be sold. And you just mentioned before that this is because they are too cheap.
Yeah, but it's usually in villages. It's kind of, I mean, this particular work, it's like houses that are in rural areas that are empty because, I mean, I think it's, again, generally the situation everywhere that people, I mean, are less and less living in rural areas. And here it's especially like that. So it's completely absurd how expensive are, for example, apartments or even for renting or not for buying, of course, in Belgrade. In the city center, it's completely insane, and how cheap can these, for example, old houses in some rural areas be? It's like 1 square meter in central Belgrade is the whole house somewhere rural.
Someone says to me that to be a good artist, you must live in London or in Paris or in New York. And by the time it's a bit changing because of the internet, because of other stuff, you can be available easier, but do you think it's still the same that you need to kind of emigrate to be a good artist?
Well, I would like to believe that it's not so. I'm not sure what's the answer. I'm afraid of the answer, maybe. But I really want to believe that it is possible to work in other cities and also in other areas. Maybe this kind of relation that we have between, for example, Belgrade and New York is kind of the same of Belgrade and some smaller place in Serbia. It's really hard for an artist, for example, to succeed and to live from their work in some smaller town in Serbia. So they all move to Belgrade usually, and here is the academy, or they move to Novi Sad, where is the academy, and the scene is here, it's more vivid, you can see things, you can meet people, which is important, of course. So maybe that same relation just goes, you know, up, and then it's kind of the same with these huge art centers and cities like Belgrade that have a developed art scene, but of course comparing with these really huge cities, it's not very big.
Sometimes the galleries also make a space for special programs, mm-hmm. like workshop?
Yeah, apart from our program, like the main part of our program are of course the exhibitions, and we have actually a lot of them. We have like 15 to 18 exhibitions a year, which is really a lot. So they're changing every 3 weeks. So it's kind of, you know, the pace is really big, but also we organize this kind of other events, some workshops. We had some, for example, printing workshops, or we have some lectures or art talks or presentations of all kind, or even some music events. So yes, apart from our program, we organize other stuff too.
If I came here with €1 million and I wanted to give you to make some extension or whatever of your program, then what would you do with that?
Oh, that's so much that I like cannot even imagine. I was thinking, like, the first thing that you said, if with that amount of money, I don't know, I would build like another, you know, kind of gallery, you know, somewhere or something like that, because that's a really huge amount of money. But of course, I mean, I'm kidding, with a little bit more money, let's say, maybe not that much. I mean, what I would like, maybe what I think it's needed actually here is this greater support for the artists, especially here at U10, because we are collaborating with young artists, some kind of scholarships, residencies, or you know, just support that an artist can, I don't know, rent a space, that they can have some funds for production, for research, that they don't have to, you know, do some maybe other jobs parallelly, just, you know, to earn money. And here, I mean, I think that would actually be the support that would be needed here. I mean, from U10, so I would like for us to, you know, give kind of more, you know, support from this financial side, and then of course other support would also come, you know, with it, for travels, for, you know, production of the exhibitions. I mean, there are so many things, because we're here working on some kind of, let's say, minimal budget, and of course you can do, I mean, with, if you want, and if you you know, have the will and the energy, and we do, you can make, you know, really good shows, which we do, but of course with more funds that would be even better.
Actually, that was a fun thing when I came here. I just realized that there is a shopping center called Galleria.
Yeah, it's a new one. Yeah. Yeah, it's, I think it's maybe the most like visited gallery, you know, in a country where there is so, you know, there is not so many funds for culture, for galleries, and then they open like the biggest shopping mall in the Balkans, or I don't know what's the, you know, their, you know, line, and they call it gallery, and then it has like some view on the river, and nobody else from the residents of Belgrade can see the river from, because of the gallery, because it's kind of not maybe the shopping mall itself, but all of these buildings are so tall that, I mean, they kind of are blocking the river for us normal people who, you know, don't live there.
Okay, we are after a crisis when everyone stayed at home, but the year before, or even the year before, a lot of people said that maybe the physical presence is kind of ending, because all the people are on Instagram, are on mobile, are on stuff. But actually the actual art pieces usually needs the presence, because of the dimensions, because of the colors, which is not really matching the monitors and the screens. So what do you think, that will this could stay? I mean, when people come to galleries to physically see the artworks, or everything will go online in some years?
I don't know, for me, and I think that we had lockdowns, and then everything kind of went online for at least a couple of months, and then we kind of now are maybe semi-online, semi-offline, because we have some online like talks and so on, and the exhibition is here set. But when it all started, I think we realized how, for me, that's maybe my opinion, it's impossible to just consume art like this online. I mean, it's just not the same. Of course, it's good if you can see it online, you can get quick information about something, you can see what's going on, and of course we cannot, even without Corona, we can not travel, you know, to all the time everywhere, so it's good to kind of have this possibility of seeing stuff online. But I think it can never beat like live, offline, you know, presence in the gallery, and as you said, you know, seeing the piece, seeing the structure, seeing the material. And it's not just about the materiality as itself, but it's, you know, being in the space, it creates a certain feeling feeling it creates, you know, so it's, I don't think that that can be replaced. And when we actually, when the lockdown started, it was a year ago now, we also had like a question, what should we do, because we had the exhibition planned, we didn't know how long it's gonna last, and here it was around 2 months, this kind of lockdown, that we couldn't work at all. Yeah. So it wasn't long at the end, but at the beginning we didn't know if it's gonna last, you know, how much. So it was the question for us, so like, what should we do? Should we continue with our shows? Should we present them online? How? Should we create some kind of 3Ds or something? Should we just post photos of pieces? Yeah. And then we kind of decided, okay, we're gonna have some online activity, of course, but we're not gonna now go fully off online, because there were so many content at that point, and I think that everyone was just overwhelmed. And of course, then, which is a good thing technically, I mean, like, you could see an exhibition that's in Madrid or New York or in, I don't know, Tokyo, is the same if you're from your room, if that's physically in Belgrade or not, I mean, it doesn't matter. So it kind of really became, you know, this feel like it's huge, and it maybe became even hard for, you know, small galleries to kind of manage to get through all of those, that content that was online. But I don't, for me personally, I think that I didn't look at online content more than I do usually, even during lockdown, because it was just not the same for me, and I couldn't wait to actually physically, you know, start physically going to galleries. And I think the visitors also had that feeling, because as soon as we opened, like, of course we had precautionary measures, we couldn't organize groups, you know, of art talks or whatever, but for individual visits, you know, just going into gallery and looking into pieces, I mean, that's the real thing.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.